Good morning, you guys. I'm actually filming this at like 10 a.m. Usually this is about the time that I wake up. If my voice does sound a little bit groggy, I woke up at 8 and I'm still sleepy tired. I already did my eye makeup. I didn't moisturize. I didn't prime my face or anything. And now I'm sitting down trying to film a first impression for you. Urban Decay Naked Weightless Ultra Definition Liquid Makeup Foundation. Asked the girl if she can match it for me, and it seemed like she didn't even know what she was doing. She said that my shade was 3.0 and she just gave it to me. I really don't know if it's gonna match me or not. If it doesn't, then I'm gonna return it and get a shade that really actually matched me. It is $39 for 1 point fluid ounce, which is your typical drugstore any type of foundation. So one of the foundation is like 4.0 fluid ounces, and that's like a MAC foundation. This is what it looks like. It looks pretty slim. It looks nice. It says shake before use. Oh, and it has a pump, which is a plus. I like foundation that has a pump because you control the amount of product that comes out. It seems like it's a very actually small pump. I don't know if you guys can see that. So to moisturize my face, I am going to be using this Nice Sol Day Wear Defense Vitamin E Moisture Cream. I'm just going to go ahead and apply this on my face and I'll be right back. So now I'm just going to go ahead and take my NYX Pore Filler Primer and just apply that onto where my trouble spots are. No matter what foundation I use, drugstore, high-end, even if I moisturize and prime my face, there's a lot of foundation that tends to cling on my dry patches. I never really found a foundation that was able to give me a flawless look. A medium to full coverage doesn't wear off and just stay in place, and also doesn't cling onto my dry patches. So if you have ever came across a foundation that doesn't cling onto your dry patches, please let me know in the comment section, because I've been on a hunch to find that perfect foundation. I did talk to you guys about the perfect foundation, which is the Benefit Flawless Hello Oxygen Wow Foundation. It still clings onto my dry patches. So I am going to take this and I am going to be using my Sigma F80 Flat Kabuki brush and with this foundation, and it's just to shake well. Oh. It has like something in the foundation. Can you guys hear that? Apply this to my fingers and then apply it to my face. So I'm going to work in small sections first. I just like to do that because, like I said, a lot of foundation tends to cling on my dry patches. And also, some foundation might set. So it is very... Oh, okay. I did not know that. It is very runny, as you guys can see. I am going to dot this on my face. Okay. It smells... Okay. Have you ever like painted your room? It smells like paint. I'll go ahead and stipple this all around my face. Does it match me? It looks like it does. It feels very soft right now. I don't know if it's gonna change. It seemed like it matches me kind of. It just seems like it's a little bit too light. I might be able to go to 4.5. It seemed like it matches me. It doesn't really cover all that much. You could kind of see. I don't know if you guys can really see, but you can kind of see where it tends to still show or peek through. I'm just going to go ahead and dot this on my face. And like I said, drag it out. It smells like paint, but it doesn't really bother me. I used to love painting my room. All it does is that it covers my face from hyperpigmentation. It doesn't really cover my scar marks, which a lot of foundation that I use don't even cover it anyway. It's kind of easy to buff in. I could tell you a little goes a long way. Like, look, that's not even a lot. That's not even a lot. That's like a small pea size, and a little goes a long way. I know that it is medium to full coverage. It can be buildable. I really didn't read any reviews going into trying this product. Usually before I try new products, especially high-end, I like to read reviews and know about it. It does seem to give a medium to sheer coverage. It feels really soft for my skin. It is clinging onto my dry patch, which I have right here. And right here. It's not doing anything on my nose, which is great because usually my nose is the problem area. So I'm back. I did my full set of makeup, which I set my foundation with my translucent powder. I did my blush, my bronzer to add a little bit more color back into my face, and also a lipstick. Even though on the box and on the foundation, it did not say anything about oxidizing. I don't know, maybe on the box maybe it might say that it does, but I don't know where it does. When I first put it on, it was a little bit too light for my skin. When I started to put on my translucent powder, it started to change color. So now it actually really does match my skin. So I'm gonna go ahead and go throughout the day and see how it wears, and I will be back like middle to the ending of the day to let you guys know how I like the foundation. The end of the day, it's like about 7 almost 7:30, and I just want to tell you guys how I feel about this foundation. So I do like it. It feels amazing. I'm actually in my kitchen right now, but I do like it. It feels amazing. It is very, very soft. I noticed that around maybe like 6 o'clock, I would kind of get itchy right here, and mostly a lot of foundation will make me itchy right here. I don't know the reason why, but it feels very soft. It didn't come off or transfer on any clothing. You guys can see there's no rims, and it's no patches or anything. I do have a patch right here. You guys can see that. Otherwise, this foundation gives a medium coverage. I mean, it can be buildable, but it will look cakey in that sort of way. And it does cling to your dry patches, so make sure you do moisturize. And if you do wear a primer, prime your face. But I really do like this foundation. It feels very velvety soft. So with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys later. Let me know in the comment section down below what you would like me to do a first impression of, and yeah, bye guys.